13, verses 1 through 15. Very early in the morning, the chief priests, with the elders, the teachers of the law, and the whole Sanhedrin, made their plans. So they bound Jesus, led him away, and handed him over to Pilate. "Are you the king of the Jews?" asked Pilate. "You have said so," Jesus replied. The chief priests accused him of many things. So again, Pilate asked him, "Aren't you going to answer? See how many things they are accusing you of?" But Jesus still made no reply, and Pilate was amazed. Now it was the custom at the festival to release a prisoner whom the people requested. A man called Barabbas was in prison with the insurrectionist who had committed murder in the uprising. The crowd came up and asked Pilate to do for them what he usually did. "Do you want me to release to you the king of the Jews?" asked Pilate. Knowing it was out of self-interest that the chief priests had handed Jesus over to him. But the chief priests stirred up the crowd to have Pilate release Barabbas instead. "What shall I do then with the one you call the king of the Jews?" Pilate asked them. "Crucify him," they shouted. "Why, what crime has he committed?" asked Pilate. But they shouted all the louder, "Crucify him." Wanting to satisfy the crowd, Pilate released Barabbas to them. He had Jesus flogged and handed him over to be crucified.
My name is Jim Jennings. I'm the senior pastor at Perrysburg First Church. And when we read scripture, God invites us into the story to find ourselves in the story that we're reading, in the account that we're entering into. But most often, when I come or read or hear these accounts of Jesus' passion, I know my tendency is to approach them as an observer, safely positioned outside, looking in, even detached from all that is happening, hesitant and sometimes even reluctant to really find my place in the story. And it's easy to do this, to be casual, to be disengaged, just to be an observer, never allowing myself to identify with anyone or own my part in the whole affair that's taking place. And so I watch from afar. I remain mostly unmoved by the weight of the moment, my life unchanged by the passion that Jesus endures. Good Friday, though, is a moment for us to pause. It's an invitation to consider, where do I find myself? Where do I find my place in the scene? The hymn we just sang, Ah, holy Jesus, ask the question, who was the guilty? And during Jesus' trial, Pilate even asked, what crime has he committed? But there is no answer, only more shouting. There is no answer, for Jesus is the innocent one. Who was the guilty? Jesus was not the guilty. And so as I consider my place in the story and I consider the question, who was the guilty, it hit me. I am the guilty. This should have been my trial for my transgressions. Yet by his mercy, by his grace, Jesus, the innocent one, stood in my place. And he took the guilty verdict that was rightfully mine. He took it upon himself. So who was the guilty? I was the guilty. And I invite you, where are you in this story? Are you one of the crowd shouting, crucify him? Are you Pilate? Or are you, like me, finding yourself as the one that should have been on trial? Let's pray. God, we give you thanks for the passion of Jesus. We give you thanks that we have a moment today to pause and reflect upon our place in the story, in the passion of Jesus. God, open our hearts, open our minds to what your Holy Spirit is revealing to us. God, and lead us to a place where we can have a fresh encounter with you today. We ask and we pray these things in Jesus' name. Amen.